Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you doing this fine day? Me? I'm feeling rather delighted because we have one of those delightful demos where I started looking at a piece of software that I thought would solve one thing, and it turns out it does a whole bunch of extra things. The genesis of this particular story is all about connected devices. A couple of weeks ago on the channel, we posted a video on how to take desktop video and post it to Instagram. And I had to go through all these machinations of taking the video, creating it on my computer, emailing it to myself so I could get it on my iPhone so that I could post it to Instagram. Well, the community came to my rescue, including Javier, who mentioned an app called Pushbullet, which he really likes, which allows him to push content to his smartphones from his desktop computer. I thought, I'll take a look at that. I took a look at it, and oh my gosh, it does so much more than what it might seem on the surface. It actually makes our connected devices connected properly. So Pushbullet is the topic du jour on Dotto Tech. So special big shout out and thanks to the community. I love it when you folks give me ideas for demos. It takes me a couple of weeks usually to take time and look at them, but when I do and I find a gem, boy, we all benefit. And thank you so much, Javier, for this particular one, Pushbullet. And also, we had actually several of you mention Pushbullet in the past on the channel. But here's the story behind Pushbullet. Pushbullet is really operating system agnostic. It works in every operating system, and it allows you to connect your devices to each other and be able to send information back and forth between those devices. Now, sure, we can do that with email, and we can do it within silos. For example, if you're in the Apple world and you're going to be using Apple's cloud services, you can share content back and forth in the Apple world. We can also do it with Dropbox, but we're kind of cobbling together systems by doing all of this. Pushbullet is a single app that runs unified on all of our platforms and allows them to all share pretty seamlessly between each other. And I think you'll be pretty impressed when you take a look at it, especially those of you who live in a hybrid world, who live in a multi-operating system world. So I'm going to show you this running on Android, in Chrome, and on a Mac all in this demo. Aren't you excited? Well, you should be. So Pushbullet is an app that runs on your computer. It's an app that runs on your smartphones that you download from whatever app store you happen to have for whatever your smartphone or tablet is. But it also acts as a browser plugin. But I'm just going to take you quickly through the installation process on the Mac because it'll tell us a little bit about what it does by installing it. And also to show you that it's really not all that much of a challenge to set up, but you do have to kind of think your way through it. So I'm just installing the app here on my desktop computer. I've already installed it on my notebook computer and on my two devices. I have it running here on both my iPhone 6 Plus and my Samsung Galaxy Tab Edge, or my Samsung Galaxy Note Edge, which I'm playing with and I quite like, I must say. So it's installed. Let's open it up and let's have a look at the setup process, because you can log in using credentials, using the online credentials such as Facebook or your Google identity. I've signed up for it with my Facebook identity. And as it goes, it recognizes that I've already set it up and that I have it on several different devices because I've signed up with my Facebook identity. So it was this easy to have it set up. So let's take a look at my environment that I have. Now, the whole idea is going to be to actually quickly share files and other things between the devices. So I have it set up on my Mac Pro, on my Samsung, my Samsung smartphone. I have it set up running in my as a browser extension, because you can plug it in, you can install it as a browser extension on all the main browsers or as an app. So I have it set up as a browser extension on my notebook computer. I also have it set up as an app on my desk, on my notebook computer, and I have it set up on my iPhone. So you can see I've got it set up and everything. Now the cool thing is, depending on how deep you want to get in the pool, you can set this up to basically to just share files back and forth or that sort of stuff. Or we can actually go in even deeper and have it working at an operating system level where it's actually copying your clipboard back and forth and that sort of stuff. Actually, before we start sharing files back and forth, let me actually show you that those setups and the preferences. So I'm here in Pushbullet. I'm going to go under the Pushbullet menu into preferences, and there we can see the different settings that we can choose to set up with Pushbullet. Now, the most important ones are allowing you to enable notifications, which basically allows you to be notified of any activity in Pushbullet by putting it in our top menu bar. I don't mind that. I'm going to put that in. It uses a few system resources, but it shouldn't be too arduous. Hide it in the dock when the application is closed. That's fine. Universal copy and paste is one that I haven't enabled, but I'm not sure. I mean, it sounds very cool, but I'm concerned as to whether or not it will work seamlessly, because it's quite complicated what it does. This is what I was talking about as far as copying something in your operating system level using copy and paste, and then having it that snippet copied and available on your mobile device. I think that's going to use a fair bit of bandwidth, and I just don't trust it. And I don't really see the value, to be honest. I could see it occasionally for maybe a password or something like that, but I don't see the value myself, so I'm just going to leave that turned off because I think it could be trouble. I just closed that down by accident. Let's just go back in because I want to show you the last of them. Showing my phone's notifications, I'm going to turn that off. I've got that ability built into iOS, and I get messaging coming up on my computer screen of notifications that are on my phone. I'm not sure I really like that. I tend to feel that often causes extra levels of distraction that I don't really need, so it's something that I'm happy to have turned off, but that's my personal choice. And finally, if you've got that turned on, you have to set it up with iOS and Mac notifications, so I'm going to leave that turned off. So that's the basic setup. Let's take a look at how we actually share something back and forth. So what you do is you just click on the plus, and it almost works like an email system. You choose whatever of your devices that you're set up that you want to push something to. Now, the cool thing is if you have this, say, in your family, you can with friends, you can push to other devices. It just doesn't have to be your devices, but in your address book, you can have other people's devices. I am just going to send this to my mobile phone, which I call Fishport Mobile, and so that's addressed there. So this can be to my device, it could be to anybody else who's using Pushbullet's device if I have Pushbullet's apps, if I have their address. I am going to now add, this is going to be important stuff. And if I want to attach a file, I can click here to attach a file, click in the center of it, and now I can navigate through to any document that I want, anything that I want to include, any graphic, anything like that. Let's see, do I have a graphic here that I could quickly add? What's that one there? There's a picture of Susan. Let's just make a little mail gif. There is. So a little image that I wanted to send, I want to use. So I save it there, and now I push it. Now, what should happen is it's being now sent to my smartphone. And if I take a look on my smartphone, there it is. We can see right on my notification screen that I have a graphic that has been sent to me. So if I unlock my phone and I go into Pushbullet, we see the app running here. I can see that I've got here, I can save that photo to my own into my own album, and so I've got access to it all here. Isn't that awesome? So it's that easy to transfer any type of data to our smartphone. Now, where it starts to get really cool is when we start thinking about sharing information between our mobile devices. So for example, I live in a hybrid world where I have some Android and I have some iOS devices. If I want to take something and I want to send it to my Android device, I don't have to use email. I can use Pushbullet to send from my iOS or from any of my my desktop computer or from my mobile. So I want to send it to my Samsung, to my Galaxy Tab here, and I'm going to call it cross promotion, because that's exactly what we're doing here. Okay, so we've got that going, and again, I can attach anything, including my location. This button here will actually include a map with my location, which is an interesting way to go about things. I can send links, I can send files. Let's send this crazy picture of my cat. It'll take a few seconds to go through, but yeah, the cat was just laying down like it was a rug the other day. So I'm going to send that, and I say push it. Now it's uploading the file, and it's going to be pushing it through to my Samsung, to my tab. So let's jump over and let's take a look at the Galaxy now. And here is my Galaxy tab running. And if I go to Pushbullet here, so this could be any Android device, there sent just moments ago is the picture that I sent. Now let's think about this for a second. Look at what we've done. We've taken information from our desktop or notebook computer in any operating system. We've sent photos, files, music, web clippings. We've sent it from our desktop or notebook to our mobile device or exchanged information between our mobile devices. Again, operating system agnostic, going from iOS to Android, Android to iOS, iOS to Windows. It doesn't matter. We can exchange it all back and forth using this simple, it turns out, free app called Pushbullet. I think it's a winner. It certainly makes all of our connected devices connected, does it not? That's it for today. I hope that you found this video to be useful, and I imagine a lot of you are going to try and download this and start playing with it. Let me know what you think about it. Please give us comments below and let us know what you think of this app. And if you have any other suggestions, I'm all ears and more than happy to create a demo if it's something that I think that the entire community is going to be interested in. Now, there are three ways for you to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is you can subscribe to this channel, which we encourage you to do. Second, I also encourage you to subscribe to my newsletter. Then you will hear about my upcoming live events, which I do on a regular basis. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded site. We're supported by the people who view us through the crowdfunding site Patreon, and there are perks attached to being a supporter of Dotto Tech. I encourage you to drop by and visit our Patreon page and have a look for yourself. That's all the time we have today. I hope that you found today useful. Till next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.